Well, welcome back to the Steve Rob Show. Today, I got my little furry friend down here, and I'm going to talk about him. This is my buddy Jake. He's a Weimaraner, and I'm going to tell you everything you want to know about a Weimaraner and stuff that you don't want to know, stuff you should know, whether you should buy this dog, whether you shouldn't buy this dog. What do I think about this dog? Let's get to it right now. Got a nice cold beer over here. I got my Wells IPA. Let's sit down. Let's have a little bit of a talk. Okay, Jake. Okay, sit. You sit. Sit. Be nice. Okay, there. Sit. Come here. Sit. Stay. Okay, you stay. Okay, guys. This is my buddy Jake. And Jake's 9 years old. This is my Weimaraner. This is my best buddy right here. And most of the time, he's on this blanket sitting over there watching me. Now, what do you want to do? Go walking around here? Come here, sit down. Sit down and be nice. Okay. There. Now, look in the camera over there. There you go. There. Okay, guys. Let's get to it right here. We got Jake the Wonder Dog here wandering around. But usually, I tell him to sit over there in the corner on this blanket. He stays there. He doesn't even move. Okay. Let's get to it right now. Okay. Well, here we are. Well, you got to meet my little buddy Jake there. And I'm going to do a little bit of review on my dog. And I've had a lot of people over the last couple of years. I've shown a couple of shots of my dog there, and people are interested in the dog, I guess. So I thought I'd have a little discussion about Jake the Wonder Dog, I call him. And it's my favorite beer, Wells IPA. So let's a little bit of a cheer to our little furry friends. Okay, where do we start here? First thing I'm going to say to you right now, right off the bat, don't get a dog like Jake. One of the smartest dogs I ever had in my life. Really smart dog. And when you get a dog that's smarter than you, you're in for trouble right off the bat, because this dog is smart. I've had so many dogs, and I'll tell you what, this dog is super smart. The dog will not learn some stuff that just doesn't make sense. It's amazing how, since I've owned this dog, not once as a puppy did it ever chew on anything or knock anything off the table or anything. If you read up on the dog, they'll say the dog's very aloof. And it is. Like when I'm opening up my screen door, let the dog out, he watches me and he watches the door handle, and he won't go through if he thinks that door's going to move a bit. It's amazing how cautious the dog is. Now this dog, it says in the book when we were looking to get a dog, it says this dog is a mix of Great Dane, German Shorthair Pointer, English Pointer, and I believe Bloodhound. And this dog is originated from Germany, lives about 11 to 13 years, and is considered a sporting breed. And I would say this dog is not suitable for a lot of places. Like if you don't have like a half decent backyard, or if you're in an apartment, I would never have a dog like this in an apartment. This is a high active dog. This dog needs a lot of energy, you know, to go around and everything. And the dog is fearless. And if you take a look at the descriptions of the dog, of the Weimaraner, he is completely fearless. I mean, there's nothing that scares this dog. He will pretty well eat anything. He's been sprayed 3 times in my backyard by skunks. He killed 1 skunk. He's not afraid of a skunk. Coons, you wouldn't believe the coons we got around here. They're all big. They're all big and fat, and they're all lazy coons. And when he takes off down the end of the yard and he sees a coon in the back of the yard there, that coon can barely get up that fence, and he's tearing the rear end right off of that coon like something fierce. But if you ever get a raccoon turn around and grab the dog would be in big trouble. Because a 40, 50 pound coon, look out. It'll take on I don't care what kind of dog you have. But this dog, if there's anything around our property, it is so protection. Like, buddy of mine's got a German Shepherd, and I thought that dog was really protective. This dog is super protective of the whole household. Nobody's going to come to my house. He'd just eat them to pieces, I'll tell you right now. And that's one of the cautious things. I really don't care for the dog too much. He's way overprotective. And we always got to make sure, like when somebody comes over, I got to introduce the dog to them and make sure that, you know, dog don't go crazy. But the dog is really strange to me in some instances. I'll tell you how many times it's happened to me in the middle of the winter. The windows are all closed, of course. The furnace is on and the dog is in the back bedroom laying on one of the beds. All of a sudden, he'll take off and run right to the front of the house and start barking at the front window. I'm looking out and there's a cat walking around on the sidewalk in the snow. Now, how did he know that? And I'm thinking, I've never seen that before. But this dog does this all the time. If there's anything around anywhere, wow. I don't think it could smell the cat out there. I don't think it could hear it. I'm not too sure what he did, but it is just amazing to have a dog like that. But like I say, you got to be very cautious having that type of breed because they're very protection of the family. Like, it would be more or less my wife's dog. Most dogs are attracted to one person in the family, and it would be my wife. And he follows her around all over the place. And I can remember maybe when the dog was 6 months old. Get a little dry here. Let me have a little bit of a sip. When the dog was about 6 months old, I had him up at my camp, and it was in the fall, and I had a huge flock of geese land in my field. And of course the dog's ears are right up, and he's jumping at the window there and wants to go outside and see these geese. So I thought, well, that'd be fantastic. I'll just open the door and just let him go, right? Well, as soon as I went to the door handle to open up the door, dog didn't want to go outside. And I thought, like, what's going on here? And I looked out in the front lawn about maybe 40 feet out. There was a huge timber wolf. And if you ever seen the timber wolves up in northern Ontario, you could put them across the tailgate of a pickup truck and the head and the tail will hang over the back of a full-size pickup truck. Massive. They're just huge animals. And he seen that timber wolf and he would not go outside. I think if he did go outside, the timber wolf would love to see him too. But very nice dog to own. Very easy to take care of. Like, they do not shed. A friend of mine has a lab, and you wouldn't believe the hair all over the place. This dog here, yeah, it does shed a little bit, but it's not like a double coat or anything like that. Very easy to maintain. My dog will not go in swamps and that kind of stuff. I've had other people come up to my place in the up north, and I've got like a pond there where I get my water. And especially labs, they'll just jump right in the swamps. They'll go everywhere. My dog, the Weimaraner, does not like to get dirty. It will not go into a swamp and get all messed up with mud and everything else. The dog keeps himself clean like a cat. And it's a very unique dog. I don't see too many. When I go to my vet, he said he's only got three Weimaraners in his practice. There's not a lot of them around. We bought that dog, well, the dog's 9 years old now, and it was $1,000 9 years ago for that dog. And it's been a terrific dog, great family pet, smart, very easy to train for common sense stuff. But you can never train that dog for some stuff if the dog don't think it makes sense. You know, and it's hard to describe like what doesn't make sense, but yeah. A mind of their own, a big time mind of their own, and very easy to train in the house. Like, it wasn't hard to train that dog to go outside all the time, and we don't have any mistakes in our house or any of that kind of stuff. The dog is just super intelligent. And would I get another one of these dogs? No, I'm not going to get another one of these dogs. The next dog I'd like to get is a German short hair pointer. I really like this dog. He's been a really terrific buddy of mine, and a lot of times, yeah, he's just laying down over there watching me talk in the camera. But I would recommend this dog for people who are active and for people who are going to spend time with the dog. This dog just loves affection like most other dogs, and is always there to please you. And I could be gone 10 minutes, come back, and you think I was gone for 10 years. And you can't ask for a better companion. And I think I'll always have dogs all my life, and I enjoy them. One of my favorite was a little beagle. Just love the little beagle. So I just thought I'd bring that up today and mention my little furry friend Jake. So thank you very much for dropping in. Subscribe if you like. Come back again. Let's have some more fun. Bye, guys. I gotta finish this off. Take care.